Lake Austin is what we call a constant level water lake. Plus, this lake never fluctuates more than 8 inches at any given time. And yeah, that's whether we're in a drought or a flood. And believe me, we're in a serious drought right now. But my next question, and it is a question, are we ready to splash down there? All right, folks, well, I'm no longer your driver. I'm now your captain. Now, you just call me Captain Vic. Come on, Howard, let's show them how we do this. The folks, y'all feel free to stand up and walk around as long as you're on the water. But you jump. You're on your own.
Back in the bath. I was out and knew there was a party going on. There was a fishing and a spam.
Get those folks over there quacking away. Limestone rock. If you came back about a couple of months from here, a few months ago, and these leaves weren't here, you'd see this is really one big limestone rock. Well, you see that brown boat slip there? Wait till we're across from it. There's a rock stairwell, and it winds its way all the way up that hill. But they didn't bring rocks into that, folks. They carved it right out of the existing rock that it is. You should be able to see it. Like I said, this is a really bad angle with the sun. But there it is. And with those leaves right there, you can see it go all the way up the hill. But, and you know, I can see it all day long, but it's real hard to see it. It's right behind that brown boat slip. I'll tell you what, I'll get you closer to the shore here, but between that gas station and these little gray boathouses there, that area right there is about 3 feet deep. And if you see that trail of mud, that's where a boat just went through. He kicked it up off the bottom. That's how shallow that is.
Wow.
And, well, you see that new one up on top they just built, that Spanish-looking house? They got a light rail that gets them down to the boat slip. Pops out right behind that brown boat slip right there at the end where that sun's shining in the water. We're going over there, and you'll see when we get over there. It's literally rock from top to bottom. Yeah, just like right behind those gray boathouses there, folks. I'm telling you, these are just limestone rocks. That's one reason you see so much limestone in the buildings and homes around here. We do not have a shortage of limestone. But folks, back to Miss Angelina Everly, the lady downtown firing a cannon. Yeah, we really did have a cannon that sat there on the Conning Main. And the building it sat in front of, the General Lands Commission building, that's where we kept the archives back there. Matter of fact, we kept that cannon loaded and ready to fire at all times. Well, Sam Houston, after we lost the Alamo and our dealings with the French, yeah, he thought we were way too vulnerable and way too far from our Gulf Coast. Yeah, he wanted us to move the capital to Houston. Well, folks, the good citizens of our country, now they voted him down at least 5 times. But you know, he got so disgruntled, he actually sent some of his troops down here in 3 wagons to steal the archive. But now, he also gave the order of no bloodshed. Yeah, just steal the archives and come back home. Well, they showed up here in the middle of the night, started loading those wagons, but they woke Miss Everly. Now, when she went outside and saw what was going on, she ran over to that cannon, fired it. Now, they said it blew a hole in the General Lands Commission building, but they said they could hear that for 15 miles around. Now, folks, it ran off its troops with what archives they gathered up, but it also alerted the townspeople. Now, they formed a posse with cannon in tow. Now, they followed up on Brushy Creek, about 18 miles north, right about where Round Rock is today. Then they caught up with them, surrounded them, of course, and that cannon pointed at them. Now, they did relinquish the archives. But you know, we were so appreciative of that dastardly deed, we did erect that statue for that very reason. And yeah, folks, this is us at our lowest right here. We're about 8-9 inches below normal and have been for several years. Quack and Larry. Oh, look at them Texas folks out in the front row. All righty then. There's Frank of St. Louis in the back. Hey, folks, y'all have never seen a Texas-sized largemouth bass? Take a look under those umbrellas. We caught that one right here in the closet. Yeah, we had to stuff it down because it's only fish. Just to let you see what we do breathing these waters. Well, personally, I do attribute that to the duckweed, but that's my personal opinion, you know. And yeah, you see that double paddle riverboat over there? That's the Commodore, our mothership. Well, that's a 250-passenger riverboat. And we also have the Commodore Pup. It's about 50 passengers smaller than this one. But these two riverboats, they were actually built on this river back in 1950 by the Fowler family. Yeah, Pappy Fowler and his son Dudley Fowler, a couple of Navy men. But you know, they actually built these boats on this lake. Because folks, there's nowhere on this lake to get something that size on or off. You know, those boat ramps we just came in on, that's as large, if not larger, than any boat ramp on this lake. But you know, that boat's been on this lake, well, 63 years. And we had a big 60th anniversary party for it. Actually, we've had one of the singer-songwriter from Fort Worth, Texas, Jerry Lynn Williams, a really good singer-songwriter in his own right. But you know, I thought I'd share that with you as we wobble our way towards that statue. Now, Stevie sings it, but they both play guitar on it. And matter of fact, Jimmy does it there right to get the beginning, too. We'll be right back.